Judge in Evansville has struck down Indiana's ban on same-sex marriage. While several counties immediately started issuing marriage licenses to same-sex couples today, Tippecanoe County did not. News 18's Brittany Tyner was at the courthouse where one couple was denied when they tried to get a marriage license. Brittany, what was the reason the clerk denied them?
Dan, the marriage license application only has the option of one man and one woman, which is why Krista Coffey says she couldn't issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples today. Even though they weren't married, one man says today is still a day he and his partner will never forget.
When you're growing up gay and you just want your life to be normal like everybody else, it doesn't matter. We do everything that everybody else does.
After a federal judge struck down Indiana's ban on same-sex marriage Wednesday, Wayne Applegate and his partner of 35 years went to the Tippecanoe County Courthouse with other representatives of Pride Lafayette to demand answers for why Tippecanoe County wasn't issuing marriage licenses to same-sex couples.
It's the day that we have been validated that we are not second-class citizens, and we are questioning why we are not currently allowed to do the same thing in Tippecanoe County when the federal judge has issued an immediate order.
Though they knew the chances were slim, Wayne and his partner decided they would try it anyway.
When I got there, I decided to go right ahead and let's just get a marriage license while we're doing it. Unfortunately, in Tippecanoe County, they are not ready with the paperwork yet.
Clerk Krista Coffey says the marriage license application has not been updated to reflect anything other than the option of one man and one woman. She says it is a legal violation to modify that form from the Department of Health. While the federal judge's ruling covers the entire state, Coffey believes each clerk is getting different guidance and making their own decision on whether to issue the licenses.
I would hate to issue a license and then have it have the marriage null and void because I had modified that form and on a technicality cause an issue. I'd rather do it right and make sure that we're complying with all of the laws, the federal law and the state law.
Coffey says she is waiting on answers from the state on when the application form will be updated. She couldn't give a definite time frame, but doesn't think it will take long. But her explanation isn't enough for Pride Lafayette.
Kind of wanted to know like what's going on. I'm getting as many phone calls as
right,
you are probably.
I'm sure.
So I'm just trying to figure out what I can relay, what we can do here.
Just that I'm, you know, I got the order at the same time as everyone else.
Okay.
I'm trying to not cause anyone an issue in the future by issuing a license that might then cause an issue. You know, I've been told very clearly that I'm not to modify the form, and the form still says male, female applicant.
So how are the other counties doing it, do you know?
I don't know.
Have you reached out to them yet?
No, I mean, I haven't had time.
And although he wasn't issued a marriage license, Applegate says he knows the clerk is working on it and still calls today a win.
We want the right to be married. We want the right to adopt kids. We want the rights to do everything that a heterosexual couple has. So it's a big thing today.